Super Talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Broncos going up against the Panthers. Now let's head down to Jim Nance and Bill Sims for today's matchup.
Panthers, Broncos, coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to Santa Clara, California for today's game. You've heard it so many times. You've just heard it all over again. It doesn't get any bigger than this. So if you're one of the players, how do you handle the bigness of a game like this?
Well, so many things right there in that question, Jim. One, the players, they're used to being on stage. They love the spotlight shined upon them. They've learned it from high school to college to now to the pros. But I'll say this about the Super Bowl. Here we are. Super Bowl 50. Look how far it's come since Super Bowl I. It's hard to believe it's that big. And for the players and coaches out there today, I'll just say this. I promise you, if it's the first time you've been in this game, it's going to live up to everything you ever dreamed about it being.
We go now to the third member of our broadcast team, Danielle Bellini, down on the sidelines with more on today's game.
Thanks, guys. Super Bowl 50 is a very special milestone for the NFL. Super Bowl I was played back in 1967 at the LA Coliseum. As you recall, the Green Bay Packers beat the Kansas City Chiefs on that day. But I'm sure neither of those teams could have imagined the Super Bowl growing to be as big as it is today, guys. That being said, we've got two teams out here who desperately want to make history by winning the Super Bowl tonight to ensure they're the ones that are remembered and that everyone is talking about 50 years from now. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Danielle. And now we'll go to the field. The Broncos ready to get this action started. The Super Bowl is underway. Whitaker on the return. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Heading to the huddle, the quarterback who took his team to the NFC South title in 2013, Cam Newton. Double tight end formation.
Look at that. The defensive line, everybody's shifting to the right.
In the end, it picks up only a yard. This offensive lineup often will feature the tight end in a prominent role, and that means Greg Olsen.
Yeah, Greg Olsen from Wayne Hills High School in New Jersey, coached by his father, Chris Olsen. Terrific high school, college player. And how about this? He's a terrific NFL player also. When you see linebackers moving like this, they're trying to confuse the offensive line.
Trying to power his way right up the middle. I know they want to come out and establish the run, but boy, this defense right now is not bending.
Well, they're doing a good job so far, the defense, but on the offensive side, stay patient, keep pounding that football, and hopefully you can wear this defense down as the game goes along.
Takes it from the gun. Throws the pass. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
Things haven't changed from when I played till now. With in zone coverage, quarterbacks, offensive coordinator, and receivers, they expect a completed pass, and that's what they got in this last play.
Newton's dropping back to pass once again. Brown's going to pull in the bullet pass.
Well, I think early in the game, anytime you cross the 50-yard line, it just gives you confidence that what you're doing is going to work today. Let's see if they can take advantage of that and take it on down into the end zone.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Stewart's marked down at the 47.
The Panthers running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Second down and 11. They want to keep feeding him the football.
Well, but it's third and long early in the game. As a quarterback, as an offense, you just be very careful of this situation and just try not to make a big mistake.
Now, looking at third down.
Look at that. Everybody at the line of scrimmage. The defense showing a blitz.
He's got the catch. And he's going to be tackled. And that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Jim, if it was up to me in a situation like this on fourth and short, I would not go for it. I would punt the football away, play field position, and not give momentum to the other team if you don't make it. But I'm not sure. We'll see what the coach does.
And the punt is kicked out of bounds. One of the biggest icons ever at quarterback, Peyton Manning. First down at the 21. Anderson's handed the football. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
First down at the 32. Anderson's marked down at the 34. Here's the offensive line, which must protect its quarterback today. At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Peyton Manning under center. Second down and 8. The Broncos now move the chains.
What we saw there was probably the number one route all teams work on when they go to training camp. The curl route. Find the open space in the defense. Quarterback throws it in there. Good job.
The Super Bowl. It's as big as it gets. And just the fan side of you, Phil. What sticks out in your memory bank?
Well, I think the game, one of my favorite games of all time, Jim, when you talk about the Super Bowls, the Steelers, the Dallas Cowboys, I love them both, Roger Staubach, Terry Bradshaw, and I remember the Jackie Smith drop in the end zone. Just the emotion that came from him, from all the Cowboys and Roger Staubach, it was an exciting game to watch.
Usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Second and 11. Looking long. And it falls incomplete. Jack Thompson at Washington was all over the field during his days with the Huskies.
Well, Ron Rivera, coach of the Carolina Panthers, is a defensive guy. So what did he do? He went out and got another extremely athletic guy to put in on that defense. They are going to be tough this year.
Third down and 11. It's caught by Hillman.
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming up.
The Broncos have it at the 44. Running right through the trenches.
Broncos go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
The Panthers stalled on their last drive, forced to punt. So now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around, making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game.
The Panthers offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job on the offensive line.
Loss of a couple that time.
On the offensive side, if it's third and long, there's very few plays that you have that are going to pick this up. So be careful in a situation like this.
The Broncos defense now is going to go nickel.
Looking to go deep. Hauls it in. How about that play by Cam Newton? The man is big and strong, can run, and he can throw it down the football with anybody. What a beautiful throw. Good job by the defense. All shifting inside. They're expecting a run up the middle.
Jonathan Stewart with the football. As we get a look at this defense, DeMarcus Ware, a player opposing offenses hate to have to face.
Oh, my gosh. And where is he going to line up? We've seen him line up outside. He lines up as an inside linebacker. You know, he dropped back in pass coverage. But when he rushes the quarterback, one of the best in the league.
Greg Olsen has the catch. That's his first reception today.
There is nothing like having a great tight end in your offense now. There's so many things you can do with them. Remember, they're in the middle of the field. They can go down the middle. They can go outside. They can go short. They can go across. They can go out. Tough to cover the tight ends in this league now.
Stewart's going to secure the football on the toss. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You've got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it.
Touchdown, number one at the Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl is like no other game out there. It's so big. The tension is so much more than the other playoff games. And when you score first, that is a big, big deal. More than anything, it's a great relief to get that out of the way.
The Broncos back deep, ready to receive. Bolden's going to test the coverage this time. Broncos offense getting ready to start this drive. I'm sure they're having a hard time letting go of what happened last time when they had the football across midfield and field goal range and failed to come away with any.
Ball was out.
The offense was able to recover the ball. What a lucky break this time. They fumble, but they recover it and maintain possession.
NFL teams, the offense, every single day they work with anybody that's going to handle the football. How to hold it? He didn't do a good job that time. That's why he fumbled.
Airing it out. Makes the play.
There's just so few quarterbacks who know how to throw it high and far anymore. Nice job that time by the quarterback. That throw was right on the money.
First down and 10. Anderson's going to take the handoff now.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Two tight ends on the field here. Second and 8. Vernon Davis hauls it in. That's his first reception today.
Nice catch that time by the receiver on the slant route. Quarterback puts it right on target.
First down here. Anderson's going to secure the handoff. And that's a gain of 9. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The Panthers' defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Second and short. Looking for some daylight up the middle.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
They break huddle at the 18-yard line. Peyton Manning will be taking this one from the gun.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Unable to bring it in.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Manning's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Second and 10. Knocked down as he fires it. Coming to the line at the 18. Third down and 10. And incomplete. What a hit that time.
Davis is one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
No doubt about it. Put three on the board. As we edge closer to the second quarter, they edge a little closer on the scoreboard with the successful kick.
Yeah, that was good for the team. It was a big confidence boost, and now they know they can do it on the offensive side, and now it's up to the defense to keep this thing going.
And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Panthers offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Love what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did.
Mark him down for another reception.
There are so many players now in the NFL that are good. How about this tight end? He has got so much talent. That time he hauls in the pass and just makes it look so easy.
First down coming up. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Corners are backing off here. That's Newton over to Olsen for the catch.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
We're back here to start the second quarter. And, partner, when you're in a tight defensive game like this, what does an offense have to do to open this game up?
Well, I think what happens sometimes in situations like this, Jim, you know, the offense, they plan for the game and what they're going to do, but they come out there that first series or two, and they go, wow, these guys are better in person than they were on the film. So you've got to adjust physically. I think now that they have adjusted, we'll see if they can make some things happen.
Pass interference. Defense. Automatic first down.
Ready to go from the 13-yard line. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. The corner step back. Jonathan Stewart with the catch. That's a gain of 8.
The Panthers are trying to go down the field that time with the throw, but nobody's open. They throw it short. Doesn't fool the defense, and they get very few yards.
the catch. And he gains maybe three.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course, it'll be a touchdown.
First and goal. Brings it in for the score in the end zone. They continue to pour it on early in the second quarter with yet another touchdown here, Phil.
Well, I hope the defense learned a little something on that drive. The way they are playing is not working. So you are allowed to blitz in this league. You can take a chance. That's what I suggest. Get after it. Be more aggressive and blitz that offense.
Caldwell's going to start his return. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
Here's Sanders getting set to start this next possession. He's been off his game in this first half, Phil.
Yeah, it's been an awful game all around, but the star wide receiver is having an absolute terrible day so far. And if they want to win, he better pick it up, find ways to get open, and hope this quarterback gets him the football. You got to be able to fight adversity in the NFL or in any sports, but the fumble, not even thought about by this running back anymore. He is just out there getting it done.
The Broncos will take the snap from the 35. Anderson's tackled down at the 39.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down.
Green's playing out of position in the backfield here. Pass is intercepted. A foot race to the end zone. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
Well, when you study the offense and you know what they're going to do, you're able to make plays like that. You time the interception perfectly, you make the catch, and you take it all the way back for the score.
The Broncos back deep, ready to receive. Bolden's running this one out. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Broncos just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you've got to be smart, you've got to be efficient, and get the job done. When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
Manning comes out in the pistol. The Broncos will take the snap from the 25. And it's complete over to Owen Daniels. The Broncos have relied on very good play out of their tight end position so far. And Daniels has been a big target, and he's making some big plays.
Oh, he is making some big plays. And any time when you have a tight end good, and we'll just remember this, he is the closest receiver to the quarterback. So his chances of catching the football, they go up, and he's taking advantage of it.
But they can't connect. He had an open receiver that time and just misfired on the deep throw.
Yeah, I think he got too excited. The fact that he saw a receiver down the field wide open, he got excited. That's why he overthrew it just a little bit.
Ginn will try his return. That's a pickup of 14. The Panthers' offense was pretty anemic in the early stages, but suddenly explosive here in quarter number 2.
Wow, have they been ever. Just turned everything around. It's just good play, good hustle, and execution by everybody on the offensive side.
The Panthers snap it at the 31. That's a gain of only a yard.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run, nowhere for the running back to go, and they stopped him for a short gain.
The Panthers in the full house, set now at the line. The Panthers from the 32. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. Stewart's tackled down after a gain of two.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
The Broncos with a nickel look here on defense. The Panthers have it at the 34. As Olsen. Olsen's taken down at the 46. That's reception number four for him. The Panthers are up right now, and credit goes to the quarterback here, partner. Newton's been on the mark to this point.
He has. He's one of the better throwers in the NFL. When you give him time like he's had here so far today, he is going to put it right on target.
Second down and 10. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free.
Third long situations, a lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just great.
That's a ball that should have been caught.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. Thomas been way less of a factor in the passing game today than we're accustomed to. Maybe this is the drive that he gets things started.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. I think everybody's hoping for that he'll pick up his play and just help everybody on the offensive side. Not doing a good job. He just hasn't been crisp running his routes. And when you're not crisp running your routes, hard to get open.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Peyton Manning under center. You throw it over the middle.
Intercepted.
Tackle's made. They are completely out of sorts offensively. And now they add to the damage with the interception, Phil.
Yeah, when you get in situations like this, go back to the really simple things. Don't take a chance. Execute what you know you can do. If you do that, that'll give you some confidence, and then you'll start playing a lot better.
And it's Bob Miller who takes a stand. The line of scrimmage is the 26-yard line. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Second down and 2. Touchdown. We're halfway through the second quarter, and they're threatening to turn the rest of this game into a snooze fest, Phil.
Yeah, they are. Boy, they have really been impressive here at the start. I say this to the team that's losing. Find a way to get some courage and have some pride and find a way to get back into this game.
Bolden's got a chance for a return. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Broncos' offense has been nowhere in sight here for quite a while. Three consecutive drives that have come away empty. What about it, Phil?
That is the old phrase, MIA. They are deep.
The ball is out. Recovery by the offense. And Keekly in on the tackle. Well, the offense lucks out this time as they hold on to the football.
Yeah, I think the word luck is appropriate here, no doubt about it. Bad fumble that time by the offensive player, but at least they were alert enough to get there and get on it and keep possession of the football.
And incomplete as Daniels can't hold on.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The Broncos have to get to the 33 for a first.
Looking to go down the field here.
Jumps up and hauls it in. He's in the clear. The 10, touchdown.
Play in football is anytime you see a deep ball thrown down the field and it's caught for a touchdown. That is awesome stuff. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
They fail to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. And no return here, so Newton will start this drive from the 20. Cam Newton taking the field once again. He has been on target in this game.
On target, on rhythm, man, does he have it going. That is for sure. It's pretty to watch him play, but it's going well.
And methodically, he just throws it away. Second down following that incompletion. Lined up as the single back. Billy Brown with the catch. And a gain of four.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
Newton's completion percentage, 80% on the day. Hauls it in. Ball is out, and the recovery is made by the defense. The Broncos have tried to stretch the field vertically, and they certainly have. Manning's been dropping back and airing it out.
He's had the time to air that football out, and what we are seeing, the speed of this offense. And speed, what does it do? It can get down the field behind the defense, and they are making big plays.
The very few mistakes we've seen by this offense in the first half, but it's a big one, Phil, giving the football away.
Yeah, they've been playing well. We'll give them credit for that, but don't give the other team hope, and that's what you did with that fumble.
Before we go any further, they're going to take another look at the last play. So they're looking to see if the ball came out before the knee was down.
I think when you look at these plays, most of the time it's pretty easy to determine. Jim, you know, you can. It's just always a clear shot. When that knee hits the ground, you can freeze that shot and determine if it's a fumble or down by contact.
The run on the field is reversed.
The replay upstairs overturns the call on the field.
Yeah, good job by the officials upstairs seeing it, knowing there was a mistake on the field. That's what I love about the NFL. I'm not afraid to admit, to say they made mistakes and turn them around.
Sanders got it now. He's tackled at the 28 and a run back of about 13. The Panthers defense, where was it the last time? They could not stop the pass.
Well, they were trying. I mean, they were working as hard as they could, but hey, this group they're going against on offense, they're pretty good. Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
This will be second down. It's a two tight end formation. The Broncos take it from the 28. Looking long. And it's incomplete.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense, to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Third and 10. And Daniels has got the catch and the first.
Manning selling his play big time. The defense, they go for the run fake, and that's why he has time to throw the football and makes the completion. Good job.
Manning's completion percentage, 40% on the day. And Keekly in on the tackle.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Second and 6. Launches it down the field. Got the completion. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
Boy, just think about what it takes. It takes a quarterback with a talented arm to make this type of throw, and it takes a talented receiver to make this catch. They do both, and it results in a nice touchdown.
The Broncos for the point after. And the point after is good. The Panthers returners are back deep. They still have that big lead. Scores 28-16. Webb's taking a knee here, so the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Panthers offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake, let it go, and go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points.
Second and 8 coming up. The Panthers from the 22. The ball is fumbled. They bring him to the turf.
Fumbles are becoming more prevalent in the NFL because the defenders are getting so good at stripping that football away now.
The Broncos ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field over the last two possessions for touchdowns. Bill, can they make it 3 straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy, but trust me, I was down there one time. It's a hard job.
Glad to have you back as we come out of the 2-minute warning here in the first half.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Second and 4. Owen Daniels makes the catch. That's 5 receptions on the day.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
Manning's completion percentage, 50% on the day. Thompson's there to make the stop.
Well, they call you an outside linebacker for a reason. That means you play outside and you stop the wide runs by the offense, and he did it that time. Good job. Makes the tackle.
Second and goal from the 5. The ball is charged loose.
Jim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football, they're going to go with a pass, and if it is a pass, I will look for something quick.
Third and goal from the five. Had it for just a second, but then it came out on contact.
Well, that was some defensive effort that time to knock the ball away and deny the reception.
Yeah, beautiful job and good defense called by the defensive coordinator. But the defender timed it perfectly. And that's what it's all about in the NFL. You got to time up these throws and catches and hits exactly. And the defender did it that time.
The Broncos turn the ball over on downs.
Got to give the secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The Panthers offense now will try to sustain a drive after giving the ball away just a few minutes ago before their defense came up with a play to return the pigskin.
And they should thank the defense bailing them out of trouble getting that turnover. You're right, they're just giving the football away, not being conscious of holding it the right way. It's just been sloppy play on the offense.
The Broncos lined up in the nickel.
The D-line all talking. I think they're expecting run. That's why they're shifting to their left.
Ted Ginn takes it in. The Panthers are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Look what the defensive line is doing. They're all pinching down inside. They're expecting a run.
Intercepted. And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
Well, the quarterback, he could not see the defender. The defender in the right spot makes the catch and takes it back for a touchdown.
Taking the handoff.
So many things you can do from a 2-yard line now in the NFL. All the teams can spread you out. They can run it. The quarterback can keep it. The pick plays, the passes. Very tough for the defense to stop the 2-point conversion.
And no return here. So Newton will start this drive from the 20. The Panthers offense, I got to tell you, Phil, I've run out of superlatives.
You? When you run out of words, that is a unique situation. So, you're right, though. The offenses have been great. It's been fun to watch. I know the fans love it.
The Panthers are going to line up. Close game, second quarter. The score's 28-24. First down at the 20. Devin Funchess comes away with the football. The Panthers decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only one. That pass play wasn't good for much. So now it's second down and 9.
The defensive line now spreading out. I think they want to try to pressure the quarterback.
Charging ahead. Ware gets him for the sack. They call for the timeout to stop the clock.
The defense needed to slow this game down. That timeout might be very useful. Now they're ready to go.
Third down now. Newton lines up in the pistol. To the ground. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Broncos with no timeouts left. Following that timeout, defense back out on the field. Sanders has got it on the return. Gains 14. The Broncos had a shaky first quarter offensively, but what a different story here in the second, and that has tightened this game up.
Yes, it has. Boy, you can tell they're in rhythm, and you know, you just see it in the offense, and they get that rhythm going, their confidence is flying, and the coaches are over there. They know whatever they call, it's going to work. They're changing things here. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
And it falls incomplete.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
From the shotgun to Vernon Davis, but it's incomplete.
Well, it doesn't get much worse than this, does it? You're losing the football game. Now you're looking at third and long, and look, there are no miracles in the NFL, I'll tell you that. So be smart. If the play is not there, don't force it. Dump it off and wait for the next time you get it.
Third down and 10. Wants to go deep. And he knocks the ball out of his hands.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
This will be the last play before halftime. Launching it deep. The Broncos turn the ball over on downs. We've reached halftime, and we'll be sending it back to our studio and Larry Ridley as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Larry, thank you for that from the studios. And halftime, we're going to transition now. We're about to get the third quarter underway. Handing the ball off hasn't been something that's worked for either one of these teams today, Phil.
Well, what you have to show on the offensive side when you want to run the football, you got to show some determination. And the guys on the offensive side just get tougher and make it work.
The third quarter begins with this play. Anderson's tackled down at the 29.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short gain.
After running it, it's second down. Anderson's in the backfield, single back set. Gets the handle here.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Manning's lined up. Two tight ends set. To Daniels. Met by Davis that time.
The Broncos, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Manning's completion percentage, 40% on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Picks up 8 here.
you're running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Coming to the line of scrimmage right at midfield.
Peyton Manning under center. First down at the 50. They'll run it with him again. Anderson's tackle right at the 42.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second down, two to go.
Manning with the give.
Broncos did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
The Broncos snap it at the 36. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage. We've got a player down, so we'll step aside and be back in just a moment. And welcome back. Danielle Bellini is working on getting us an update on the injury as we return to action.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out. Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Second and 12. Going deep. Broncos in the end zone. Phil, how big was that touchdown here midway through the third quarter to take the lead?
Well, Jim, I think anytime you start getting into third quarter football games, anytime you take the lead, it's a big deal because now you're going to start affecting the play calls of the offense and the defense of the other team.
The point after try is in the books. The Panthers appear to be on their way to a walk-away victory. However, suddenly they have lost the lead. The score's 31-28. The Broncos setting up here for the kickoff. Whitaker on the return. Tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Broncos team official. Ronnie Hillman's injury looks like a broken collarbone. The team is going to take him for x-rays after the game to confirm. On top of that, they're saying it's hard to know how long he'll be out for right now, but they would not rule out an extended absence.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The Panthers snap it at the 26.
Vaughn Miller ends the play.
The Panthers have tried a couple of different ways to get the running game going, but it hasn't paid off. Stewart's been stopped from the first quarter.
Running game has no chance. That's obvious. We've seen it here today. And it's time for this offense to open it up, quit trying to run the football, and throw it down the field.
Midway through the third quarter, and this defense makes the play of the game.
Yeah, it was a nice play that time by the defense. And, you know, sometimes it's just about want to. Do you want to make the play? Are you willing to sacrifice and hustle enough to get it done? Well, the answer is yes.
Sanders is going to take this one from the 14. Gaines, 17. Now, as we see the numbers, a lot of credit goes to the coaching staff for not giving up on the run game. It wasn't working early, but has paid off late.
Jim, you were right that time. The coaching staff, they've shown a lot of patience to stay with the run game. The offensive line, of course, they're playing better. They're tough, and now they're finally getting it done.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Offense has not been hard to find at this one, Phil.
These guys are making it look too easy out there, and I can tell you from experience, and we all know it's not that easy, but I'll tell you this, fun to watch.
It's now second down. They'll go ground. Breaks free. That's a pickup of 14. He's up over 90 yards so far on the day.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
Anderson's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. They'll stay on the ground on first down. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. The Broncos have stayed with the run game today, and it's been a big part of their game plan. Anderson's been absolutely brilliant and almost impossible to bring down.
What a dominating performance by this offense today. Just coming out and out hitting the defense, giving the running back opportunities, and they are taking advantage of it.
And they bring it down at the 38-yard line.
Well, not many yards to get there on that play, but it doesn't matter. What a day and what a job this running back has done here.
Green's a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. The Broncos take it from the 38. Thompson hauls it in. Met by Davis that time.
The Broncos offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead up to a score.
Here's the handoff. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
I guess you'd say he's like a quarterback. He can't complete them all. And this running back, he can't make every run spectacular. Nowhere to go, so only gets a couple yards this time.
They bring in the extra tight end. Second down and 8. Anderson's met at the 23.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short game.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. Anderson's lined up in a single back formation. The Broncos take it from the 23. And he's thrown to the ground.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down. And they get back to the quarterback and take it down.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. Welcome back. The fourth quarter about to get underway here in a game that has had no shortage of offense.
Well, the fans have got what they paid for. They love seeing offense, and we have seen a lot of it here today, or a lack of defense. Listen, the offenses have been great, but sooner or later, the defense has to take a chance and try to make a play to turn these things around. Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
It's intercepted. He's brought to a halt. Even with all the scoring we've seen, a defense now steps up and makes the biggest play of this game as we start the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they went out there and they finally made a play. Man, did that take a long time to see the defense step up, but not too late. Good play, good interception.
Second down coming up. And the catch is made by a Jericho Country.
Well, there's not much to say about that play, Jim. It was a completion by the quarterback, and it picked up a couple yards.
Third and 5 still to go, even after that last completion. The Panthers come to the line with a bunch set. And that's going to be a three and out.
Early in the fourth, and you get the feeling this defense may have just put themselves in a golden position to win the game thanks to that stop.
Yeah, it was a nice stop by the defense, no question. I think they finally have figured out the offense where they gave themselves a chance, and they did a good job getting off the field on that third down.
Sanders has got a chance this time.
The tackle is made at the 40-yard line.
And a run back of about 11.
The Broncos have to still be thinking about that last possession. They were actually moving down the field. And then, of course, the untimely interception ended things.
Yeah, the defense, look, they got good players. And, you know, you give them enough chances, they're finally going to make the play. You have to be careful with the football. The offense was not, and that's why it resulted in an interception.
What do you think they're talking about in that huddle after that drive-killing interception?
They're probably telling the quarterback, if you do that again, we're going to kick you out. I don't know, but they got to play better.
Green's a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. Davis able to read that play and make the hit.
Hey, easy call. Be safe. Put the pressure on the other team to make the plays on the offensive side to beat you. So right here, you call something very conservative.
Double tight end formation.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Peyton Manning looking down the field. And now, Phil, with this final period underway, we get something we haven't seen all that often. A third down stop to get an offense off the field.
Yeah, the offenses have been spectacular out here today, but finally the defense said we have had enough, and they got it done on third down.
Again, takes the hit and is brought down.
The Panthers love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
The Panthers weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim. And you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in.
All is out. They recover their own fumble.
Nice job by the offense that time. Even though they fumbled the football, quick enough and smart enough to get on it right away. Well, the defensive line noticed something. They're all shifting to the left.
Third and three. Looking across the middle. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. That's reception number two for him.
The Panthers just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Newton's completion percentage, 70% on the day. And Vaughn Miller has him behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, it's just a race against time, isn't it? When the defense blitzes, can you get to the quarterback before he has time to recognize the blitz and throw it to a receiver?
Loss of two on that play.
D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
It's wide open.
The line of scrimmage, the 32-yard line.
The defensive line saw something the offense is doing. Look at them all shifting to the right.
The Panthers from the 32. Has his man. That picks up seven.
The Panthers did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
Newton's going to be in the pistol here. The Panthers will take the snap from the 25. Where's the one who made the big stop?
The Broncos defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle the runner for a loss.
The Broncos defense now is going to go nickel.
The D-line going into that spread look. They want to get to that quarterback.
Ted Ginn has the catch.
Panthers look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Now first and 10. Newton, handoff. Marshall's there to take him down.
All set up now at the 15.
This game is not over, but the quarterback knows that time is short, and his team must do something in a hurry.
Jonathan Stewart with the football.
The Panthers have really been dominant today on the offensive side. In the red zone now, they just take the football, and they run it right at the defense and pick up solid yards.
Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win.
Third and 5. They'll run it here. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment.
Here comes a field goal try to tie the game.
And the kick is good for 3. So the offense does good work to drive down the field, get in position, and kick the field goal now to tie this game in the late stages.
Yeah, you know what's going to be fun from here on out is which team is willing to take a chance. Will the offense be aggressive? Will the defense take some chances? The one that's aggressive, I think that's the one that's going to win the game.
The Broncos offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
But Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard so you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling.
Second down and 2. The give. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Green's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Tough catch on his way. Going to take it home for the touchdown. About the last thing the defense could afford to surrender at this point was a deep ball, much less the deep pass for the touchdown.
You didn't even make the offense work for it. You gave up the long pass. The one thing you can't do in this situation, protect against the long pass, and they still let it get by.
It's good. Manning certainly given his team some momentum with that scoring drive. He just put together a possession where he threw for more than 60 yards. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. Webb's not going to test the coverage this time as he takes a knee. Marshall set the head of the defense here that has a chance to close this game out if they can come up with a critical stop right now.
A lot of talented players on this defense. We know that. They got some stars, actually. All you need is one of them to come through, make that play that's going to ice this game.
Second down, late in the fourth quarter.
Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
The tackle. The Panthers are going to burn the first of their 3 timeouts right here. Trailing every third down so big at this point. The Panthers snap it up at the 26. Olsen's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
And the boy that called a timeout here to stop the clock.
Press coverage all the way. First down. Pressure on every snap now. The Panthers take it from the 38. Over to Greg Olsen with the reception. Sixth catch today so far. Going to the hurry up. Under a minute to go here. The Panthers will take the snap from the 45. Coming up, third down, a huge moment. Quarters formation here for the defense.
This has got to be a blitz. Look how everybody's crowding the line of scrimmage.
With the contact, the ball comes out. It's fourth down coming up, and of course they are going to go for it here.
Jim, no doubt they're going to go for it here on fourth down. What does the defense do? Do they play it conservative, or do they take a chance and really go after the offense to stop this fourth down play?
And he's forced to the ground. Newton's inability to produce the conversion on fourth down in all likelihood signals the end of their last chance to win this game.
In situations like this, I know the coaches and his teammates all expect him to come through, but not that time. Just not a good throw.
The Panthers defense has not made a stop for a loss throughout the game, and now they'll finally get one as a result of a kneel down to close it out.
Hey, man, you are tough. Yeah, I'll tell you. Well, you kind of explained the whole day, didn't you, about this defense? It just was not their day. They did not play well. They were not tough enough or physical enough, and they didn't have the emotion that you have to have on the defensive side here in the NFL.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
First down at the 38. Going for the deep ball. Two tight ends on the field here. Second and 10. Down the field. And it's incomplete. The Denver Broncos have won the Super Bowl. The Lombardi Trophy heading back to Denver.
Do you look down on the field right now and just imagine what it's like for them, and then even think back to the days when you had that very same experience?
Probably the only time I actually ever reflect when I see them win the Super Bowl, because I know what a special moment that is. And they're enjoying a moment that they will remember in 50 years. They'll still be able to feel exactly how it felt at this very moment.
Never be stronger than this moment. All the dreams coming out of youth. The emotion of it all, it's almost overwhelming. To realize a dream from the playgrounds, through all the practices, to one day have your hands on the Lombardi Trophy. Now that moment is realized. For the rest of your life, you'll be remembered as a Super Bowl champion. For Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long from the Super Bowl.